All right, welcome everybody to our bathroom build. And today we're working on getting our shower valve installed right here. I'll show you everything you got to do, where this block, kind of the logic behind the block, where that's supposed to go, how to get your plumbing coming out of the valve itself, how to close up this little guy right here, because that's got to get closed up, and where we're going to put our shower head. So today's vlog is all about installing this valve. All right, listen, if you're working on a bathroom and you need help, free help, no strings attached, you just want like a second opinion or somebody to actually talk to, make sure that you're going to the Facebook group down below. It's something I created for my subscribers. There's just basically a place where everybody can ask whatever questions they have, stupid or smart, and there's always going to be somebody to answer. So make sure you hit that link down below. Let's get into it. All right, so the very first thing is to figure out where do you want to set your block. When you read the instructions, this black plate is supposed to be flush with your tile. So for us, we want it to be right here because we have about 1/2 inch of our waterproofing, and then we're going to have about 1/4 inch to 3/8 of an inch of our tile. So we're right there. All that means is you get a 2x4, you put it right on the back, you screw it in, that's exactly where you want it. In terms of centering it from side to side, I want it centered on my shower pan, and my shower pan is going to be about 18 inches off of this wall. So if I'm here, I'm going to then set my valve right there, 18 inches. So that means I don't really have much room here, so I'm gonna have to drill a hole right through here to come out and then connect to my hot supply line right there. Then for my shower head, I really don't like shower heads super low, so I'm putting it right about here. And that shower head, just so you guys do have some type of measurement, is going to be figure about like 78 to 80 inches off of the ground. And the valve is about 47 to 80 inches off of the ground to me. So, and a lot of this is kind of preference. If you're shorter, put the shower head lower. If you're taller, put the shower head taller. So let's get into setting this up. All right, so I got my valve sort of set up. This is long enough to make sure I can get through this stud and then make a 90 down. My plumber always uses copper pipe around the valve itself and for the shower head. This valve is threaded, so you are able to get the threaded fittings in there, but to me, I know how to solder, so it's not that hard for me to do that. And let me show you really quickly, basically one joint on how to do that. First thing I'm going to do is go through all of my parts here and like sand the edges. And what I'm gonna use is one of these blue monster tools that I got at Lowe's. And all you have to do is just go like this. It's super simple. Bang, that's done. It doesn't get easier than that. So I'm just gonna go through and get each one of these things first. And then we're going to use this other fitting to actually scratch out the insides of these pipes. So check it out. All right, so now this tool, basically, if you push this down, just like so, out comes this bristle brush for you to basically scratch up the surfaces where it's going in. So if I have this this valve, I'm gonna go around all of these fittings now and then scratch up the inside like this. All right, so now that I did all of the prep work, all you have to do is get your flux and then basically smear it on inside all the fittings, kind of like so. Make sure you're getting enough of this stuff in there. So up, make sure that stays up. Then I'm gonna get my pipe to make sure that's all nice and legit. Same thing here. And this little fitting goes at the bottom. Cap that. Then that goes in there, cool. And then just repeat the process as you go. All All right, so now I'm going to go and start soldering. I'm going to solder every single one of these joints except this one, because this still has to go between our studs, remember that? So when you're soldering, I'm going to start on my pipe, kind of heat up the pipe for maybe 4 to 5 seconds, and then move over to the fitting and heat up the fitting itself. And then as I go over to this pipe, kind of get a little heat on that to make sure the pipe is hot enough to melt this, and then get back to the fitting, because it always goes from hot to from cold to hot. So if your fitting is hotter than the rest of the pipes, the solder will want to run that way. Same thing when you're doing this. You want to kind of get a little bit of heat on your pipe and then get this this piece hot. So check it out. I'll show you this fitting up close. All right, so now we're here. I have my mark at the bottom at 18 inches, kind of where my valve's gonna go. And I set up a laser because I have one and might as well. Do you have to set up a laser? Not really. So we're just going to line this up here, the valve first. And I'm just kind of looking right at the laser mark right there. And using some handy dandy drywall screws, we're going to set our valve. So now all I have to do is grab this piece, which is right here, solder it onto here, and then connect my supply lines to that, and I'll show you how to do that next. Before I pressure test all of this, I want to put a plug where my shower head's going to go, and I'm going to put pipe dope around it to make sure that I have no leaks. So that just goes right in here, just like so. I'm going to tighten it with my pliers. I don't have to go crazy with tightening this. That should be good. And then we are going to put our actual stem in here, the mixing stem in here. And you want to make sure that you have your handle with you, because we're going to keep it off. But when you're pressure testing it, you want to keep it on to make sure that this fitting is good. And then this fitting is good as well. So now we're just going to go turn the water on and see how we did. All right, so the pressure is on. You can kind of see the water in these pipes already. So I'm going to turn this off. And then we can start working on this. Tomorrow, I'm going to nail this all over to here. And I'm gonna nail this over to here to make sure that your pipes are not kind of kicking. Sometimes you hear kicking behind there, and that's because of this. Sometimes you turn it on and it goes like this. And that's why that happens. So to update on the project, basically our plumbing is done. This P-trap just has to kind of go like this. We'll do that tomorrow. We'll backfill this. And then tomorrow we're going to recess our shower pan, because it's going to be a curbless shower. So I want to make sure that the pan that we're using here is going to be recessed right into it. And that basically means that we have to take an inch off of this slab, self-level, and then put our pan down. It's a bit of a process, but the finish is really, really nice. And it's you can charge pretty good money for that. So if you guys want to see how that is done, make sure to hit the subscribe button. And then I'll see you tomorrow on vlog number 7.